You're watching the Video Revolution Podcast from Primo Productions.
But I learned one thing when I got in that ring. If I didn't box subconscious from here instead of here, if I'd say, now let's see, he's going to lead with his left, what am I supposed to do? I'd be on the floor trying to think it out. And I was very much disturbed when I first went into selling, because I'd go around the block two or three times trying to get courage. I'd go to that door. I'd knock on the door. They're not there. I hope. Sweetest sign in the world was the sound of a business signal. And I thought I was a coward. I was not. I was blessed in being sensitive enough to be emotional enough to be able to motivate people. Oh, my friend, what is courage anyway? Is courage getting rid of fear? Oh, no. What would there be to be courageous about if fear wasn't there? Courage is learning to sell in the face of fear, over and over. Oh, please, my friend, learn this third great principle of human engineering. Oh, my friend, let me tell you, when anyone brings up an objection, says, I want to think it over, please, please, change the language that you use into that of an assisted buyer. Based on what you told me, don't you think we better get this going right now? If you could convince yourself that these facts, you have no objection. All of us know. We agree, as you said. My friend, how many times do you use that divine example of FFF principle? Merlin Cunningham and I were putting on a seminar the other night in Anchorage, Alaska. And she said, what is the FFF principle? A little girl said, is that the fickle finger of fate? Oh, no. The feel, felt, found. My friend, please learn to use it. Please learn it. You won't believe what it'll do for you unless you try it. Feel, felt, found. Whenever a person brings up an objection or any stalls in any way, I know how you feel. You know, 8 out of the last 10 people who took advantage of this felt that way. But this is what they found. Now, what have you done? I have just had my heart broken at time when I'd go out with a new salesperson and they would get some kind of objection, and they'd say, you're not serious. Why, even a child would know. If you weren't a businessman, I'd think you were kidding me. Oh, no. When a person takes a stand, and if you can get them to change their attitude without getting their nose out of joint, oh boy, you're a human ear. I know how you feel. All of us feel that way. Now, what have you done? Why, you've complimented him. You've gone over to his corner and put your arm around him or her. And look, don't forget to say, others felt that way. I know how you feel. All of us feel that way. But this is what they have found. My friends, believe you me, you will never find anything that will cause people to act as quickly as letting them know that others did it and are glad. Oh, just try it. You see, 95% of the people are imitators and 5% are originators. When someone says, the price is too high, do we talk about price? Are we that stupid? Too high for what? Too high for the values we have built so far. You'll never do it up here. You've got to do it from your subconscious. You see, how many of you repeat an objection in the form of a question? When a person brings up an objection, don't let it throw you, but repeat it as a question. And don't mind repeating it just as strong as they do. Now, let's see if I understand you. The question in your mind is so, yeah, that's it. Now, what have you done? An objection calls for an argument. A question invites a clarification. I mean, do you know how to use calm urgency, quiet desperation, controlled excitement? Let me see if I can make myself clear in this way. Do you know why you can sell people? I'm going to tell you why you can. You've learned to lift people up to what has been coined in the field of human hearing as a decision level of motivation. You got to bring them all the way up, not 9/10. You can stand all day long with 19 cents in your pocket and you can't make a telephone call. You got to get them all the way up, and it's not easy. You see, the average person can't decide what tie to wear. My friend, did you ever have lunch with a person and they say, I want a hot